muscular, sporty in your face as well. And it will have a nice amount of horsepower, kind of brutal and aggressive. Here we go, full throttle. What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this POV review by Autotap.nl. My name is Max, and today we are checking out the all-new BMW X6 M Competition. The beast, the big coupe, and of course we have already driven the X5 M Competition, so we just wanted to see what the differences are, how it feels compared to an X5 M, and well, just for fun too, actually. So today I'm going to show you around it, show you all the cool stuff on this car, show you the spec we've got it in, and then we'll take it for a drive towards the Autobahn for an Autobahn blast. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell if you want to receive updates when we upload a new video. You can also check us out on Instagram at Autotap.nl. Alrighty, so let's take a look at the spec and the cool stuff that you get on an X6 M, which you don't get on an X6. Well, and of course some stuff you get on an X6 too, like the big new grille, which for the X6 Competition is in black. You get these massively aggressive bumpers as well, with big ass spaces for intakes, for cooling, for radiators. You get this really cool... Why is this thing always so loud? It's a thing with the X5 M and X6 M Competition. They always have to cool so long after driving. Very cool splitter at the front. This actually makes a big difference when you look at the car from the front, because it makes the front end really, really aggressive. Especially because you have all those holes, all those big vents, and then with this little, yeah, makes it really nice and aggressive. Black X6 M badge in the grille as well, which I think is a lot more difficult to steal now. I think they've changed that because of that as well. Nice and aggressive headlights, BMW laser lights. Now, this car also has staggered wheels, so that means that you get 21-inch wheels at the front, 22s at the rear, 295 section tire, Pilot Sport 4S, really good. Some black accents on the side as well. We've got a carbon black car today, one of my favorite colors. As you know, my old BMW 535D was the same color. It's just so nice in the light. When the light hits it, it turns into a little bluish color at night. It's like black, really cool. 315 section tire at the rear, Pilot Sport 4S, such a good tire. We don't have ceramic brakes though, and they are not optional on this car. So yeah, I don't know. BMW sets up this car as aggressive as possible, makes it super powerful, super fast, and then no ceramic brakes to slow it all down. I mean, yeah, it's a missed opportunity if you ask me, because the Competition, Audi RS Q8, is available with ceramics. And I think the Mercedes-AMG GLE 63S is also available with ceramics. And I know for a fact that the Porsche Cayenne Turbo S or Turbo are also available with ceramics. So BMW is a bit of a loner here in not offering that. Okay, at the rear we've got those new rear lights, of course, differentiating it from the X5. And of course the sloping roofline. We've got a nice and aggressive rear bumper as well, with two-mode exhaust system, which is never really loud or anything, but... And of course, headroom is a bit limited with the X6. So if you want really good practicality, you should go for an X5 M. But if you want the cool looks and more like muscular stuff, go for an X6 M. Because I do think that the car looks a bit more like badass, a bit more sporty, a bit more in your face as well. And of course we've got the 4.4 liter V8 biturbo engine with 625 horsepower and 750 newton meters, which is 25 horsepower more than you get in an X6 M, a regular one, a non-competition version. You do get a lot more bracing in an X6M compared to an X5M. So they did try to really make the X6M more sporty, more stiff, more agile than an X5M. And did I forget anything? We also have these optional carbon mirror caps, little spoiler here. Yeah, it is. I'm starting to warm up to these coupe SUVs a little bit. I don't know. At the start, I really hated them. But now I do think that they look kind of brutal and aggressive. Inside, this spec is really cool, if you ask me. We've got carbon, aluminium, and red and black leather. So, yeah, it looks really, really nice. Seats are really soft. The leather is really, really good. And I like this carbon, aluminium, red leather. This combination is a really good one. The stitching is very nice as well, with that pattern in there. And again, I mean, this door is a piece of art. Just the combination of that aluminium of the Bowers & Wilkins diamond audio combined with that carbon, another strip of aluminium, and that red leather. I just really love this. This is a really good part of this interior. Of course, we've got the new setup, so we can adjust the engine, chassis, steering, brake, and MX drive. Now, we can also program that on the M1 and M2 buttons, of course, so we have already done that. But before we go on, I just want to let you know that we've got a new watch in our store, ignitioncollection.com. Now, this is our flagship, the Lugano Diver, automatic movement, helium release valve, sapphire glass, ceramic bezel, rubber strap or steel bracelet. This is, you know, a serious watch. This is really our pride and joy, but we've got a new one out as well. It's called the Ascona, and it is a really nice sporty watch with a steel bracelet, blue dial, also Swiss made. All of our watches are Swiss made, and that one is a little bit more affordable than this one. So if you're interested in either of these watches, go check out ignitioncollection.com. You can click in the top right corner. All right, let's take it for a drive. And to do that, we will start in regular mode. So we'll just put the car in drive, and we've got efficient, comfort, 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 as you can see. Because this is actually one of the few weak spots of this car, weak points, because they at BMW M have tried to set up this car as sporty as they could to make it handle like a true BMW M car. And well, it does. It is ridiculously impressive how they have been able to make this 2300 kilo car handle like this, feel much lighter and more agile. But it does mean that it is compromised for everyday driving, and that concerns the suspension mostly, because it is really firm, it is really hard, and you've got those massive 21 and 22 inch wheels, of course. Combine that with that stiff suspension, and well, this is actually a very smooth road, so maybe this is not the best place for me to show you guys. But when you drive it every day, I've been driving it for a few days now, it can be quite stiff and quite hard and quite uncomfortable. So that really is something you have to consider if you are considering buying this car to drive it every day. You can actually hear it. You can hear those. Normally you don't hear that on this road, but in this car you can hear and feel everything. I just wanted to get that out of the way, because you really have to be aware of that. Now, we'll put it in M2 mode, which cannot be activated. Why? Yes, now it can. And that means that we've got Sport Plus for the drivetrain, Sport for the suspension, Sport for the steering, Sport for the brakes, and the exhaust is also open. And we've got four-wheel drive Sport for MX drive. Now, this means that everything has sharpened up, everything is at its firmest, and the drivetrain is so freaking aggressive now. So are the brakes. You really have to get used to that, because they are really sensitive now in sport mode. especially at the very start of the pedal, it is really, really aggressive. So you have to get used to the fact that when you hit those brakes, I mean, you're diving forward. Another weak point of this car, sound. This engine has never really been known to sound that good, but now with all the OPF nonsense, this exhaust or this, it has just been stuffed. It's just gone. All the sound is gone. You have this vague sound of a V8, but there's really nothing there. It's a shame, but of course this is easily solvable by just putting an aftermarket exhaust on it and it will sound a lot louder. But it is a shame because this drivetrain is one of the most impressive ever, really. It is ridiculously powerful. That ZF 8-speed combined with that 4.4 liter V8 bi-turbo, it is a match made in heaven. The drivetrain always feels super powerful. Also from like down low, there is hardly any turbo lag, and the torque in this engine, the flexibility, the elasticity in this drivetrain is really impressive. I've talked about this before when driving the X6 M50i, I think, or an M50i at least. But this M version of this engine is even more impressive. And that is what you remember. That is the feeling you get every time you drive this car. And as I said, what you remember when you are finished driving, it's that surge of power you get every time in this car. And the ability of stringing together a sequence of corners in this car. I mean, it's 2.3 tons, it's massive, it's high, it's heavy. And the way this thing goes around corners is absolutely mind-boggling. They have done such a good job. Once you turn this car on and you go for like the sporty stuff, it is really impressive. And we know you can also slide this car around, which is even more insane, of course. It's not as... how do I put this? It's not as finessed as some other BMW M cars, like an M3 or an M4, or even, you know, a CS or a GTS, which you can drive like with your fingertips. This is more about brute force. It's more about that drivetrain forcing this car around corners, and BMW M forcing, you know, the chassis to cope with it. So I've got a speedo right there for you guys. So we'll see what this car feels like on the Autobahn. Here we go, full throttle. Top speed is 250 kilometers an hour limited. If you go for the M driver's package, it will go to 300, which is also quite ridiculous, especially since I told you guys that we don't have ceramic brakes. We have regular M brakes. This tire pressure monitor message, I don't know why we get this, because all the pressures are in green, so don't worry about that. But the performance of this car is seriously impressive. We did a measurement from 100 to 200, 8.83 seconds, which is really fast. Probably even crazier is the fact that we did a 0 to 100 in 3.6 seconds. BMW says it should be done in 3.8. We measured 3.6. That's absolutely insane. That was 300 kilometers an hour. Braking. Now, braking performance of these M brakes is actually not that bad. I mean, they are powerful enough. It's just that when you start repeating it, they start fading a little bit. after you've slowed down, you can repeat it all again, because you need so little space for this car to stretch its legs. It is insane. And well, I'm happy to tell you that we've got some more insane stuff in the future, because we have a G-Power version of the X6M planned, probably with some different downpipes as well, so that will sound crazy as well, and it will have a nice amount of horsepower tuned by G-Power. I mean, we know that this engine is really, really good for tuning, and that there still is a lot of reserve in there. And I mean, I guess the setup of this chassis, it can handle a lot more power, because it's just insane. Okay, so this truck overtaking has given us the opportunity to slow down a little bit. We'll put it in manual, six gear, full throttle, 100 kilometers an hour. Torque pull. And that is actually seriously impressive as well. I mean, the way this car, or this engine, picks up, and performs in this in-gear pull is really good. Yeah, it's crazy. I don't know what to say. I keep repeating myself, because it's just the only way to describe this car. It is absolutely insane. It's crazy that we are here now, that this is normal. These massive SUVs are able to do this. So compared to an X5M, I have to say that I don't really feel the difference compared to the X5. This having more bracing and being more sporty, I don't know. I felt like the X5M was plenty sporty as well. You do feel like, though, in the X6 that you're a bit more cocooned. You're a bit more deep inside the belly of the car. And I also think that the windscreen is a little bit more angled. You sit a little bit lower as well. I think they have done that really well to make the difference between the more practical X5M and the more sporty X6M. Performance-wise, of course, the X5M competition and this X6M competition, they have the same power output, but because this is aerodynamically a little bit more efficient, you know, it's a little bit sleeker, it will perform a little bit better. This, I said, 8.83 seconds, 100 to 200. X5M competition, 9.14. So it's like a 3/10 difference, which is, I mean, noticeable in the list. It's not absent, so I guess the difference is there, but you don't really feel that, of course. So we're back in the Netherlands, fun is over. That is it for this review. Don't forget, we've got that G-Power X6M coming up, so stay tuned for that one. For now, this is it. I hope you enjoyed it. You can subscribe by clicking the big button right there. You can also check out this video or go check out this playlist. See you at the next one. Bye.